Hello friend, welcome back to our tutorial, Designing an Impressive Architectural Building in AutoCAD 2018 Metric. If you have been following along, go and open the file 00_044_DIABM where you save it. Go to the Quick Access toolbar and click the Save As icon, or hold down Ctrl, Shift and type S on your keyboard to bring this Save Drawing As dialog box. Rename this drawing to 00_045_DIABM and click the Save button. Hold down the Shift key and your middle mouse button. Go to the Home tab, Layer panel and click the Face Layer button. Select this surface, this roof. Let's escape to get out of command. Go to the Home tab, Layer panel, click the down arrow and select the cabbage layer to make this the current layer. Select the freeze layer again and select this surface to freeze it. Press escape to get out of the command. Now go to the Home tab, Draw panel and click the down arrow, select the construction line command. Type V on your keyboard and press enter. Zoom in into this area and snap in, use the endpoint object snap and snap to this vertex. Press enter to end the command. Let's enter to repeat the construction line command again. Type H on the keyboard and press X. Snap into this vertex. Press escape to get out of the command. Press enter to repeat the construction line command again. Type H on the keyboard and press enter. Snap into this vertex. Press escape. Now go to the Home tab, Layer panel, click the down arrow and for the R7 layer. Go to the Home tab, Draw panel and select the construction line command. Type V on your keyboard and press enter. Snap at the endpoint of this surface. Press escape to get out of the command. Now select this line, right click, isolate object. Go to the Home tab, Modify panel and select the fillet command. Type M on your keyboard and press enter. Fillet this line to this line. Press escape to get out of the command. Now go to the Home tab, Modify panel and select the offset command. I specify offset distance from type 750 mm. Press enter. Select this line and offset it into this direction. Select this line, offset it into this direction. Select this line and offset it into this direction. Go to the Home tab, Modify panel and select the fillet command. Type M on your keyboard, press enter. Select this line, offset it to this line. Select this line, offset it to this line. Select this line, fillet it to this line. Select this line and fillet it to this line. Press escape to get out of the command. Select the internal lines and hit delete on your keyboard. Go to the Home tab, Modify panel and select the line command. As specified, first point prompt, click on this area. Go to the status bar and turn on the polar tracking. Click this arrow and make sure that the 45 degree incremental angle is checked. Click into drawing area to close this window. Move the mouse cursor and snap into 45 degree angle. In my case, 135. Click. Press enter to end the command. Go to the Home tab, Modify panel and select the line command. At the specified first point prompt, click on this endpoint. Move the mouse cursor and use a 45 degree angle. In my case, 225. Click. Press escape. Press enter. Repeat this process and all to draw 45 degree angle line on all the corners. Go to the Home tab, Modify panel and select the fillet command. Type M on your keyboard and press enter. Fillet this line to this line. This line to this line. Press escape to get out of the command. Now type DI on your keyboard, press enter. As this is my first point prompt, snap into this point, move the mouse cursor into this direction and snap to this point. Type, press the F2 key on your keyboard to bring to the text window. Highlight this figure, hold down the Ctrl key and type C on your keyboard to copy this figure. Click into the drawing area to close the text window. Go to the Home tab, Modify panel and select the line command. As specified first point prompt, click on this endpoint, right click and select the quick call option in the window that appears. Backspace to delete the zero. Hold down the Ctrl key and type V on your keyboard to paste this figure. Now multiply this figure to 0.75 and press the equal to, click apply, move the mouse cursor, turn on the auto mode on the status bar, move the mouse cursor on the positive z axis and press enter. Press enter to end the command. Hold down the shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit. Select this line. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the copy command. As specified in base point command, copy this line to this endpoint. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the home tab, draw panel, click down and select the polyline command. Use the endpoint object snap and snap to the endpoint, this endpoint, this endpoint, this endpoint, this endpoint. Type C on the keyboard to close the keyboard. Press enter to repeat the command again. Snap from this endpoint, this endpoint, this endpoint. Type C on the keyboard and press enter to close the keyboard. Press enter to repeat the command. Snap from this endpoint, this endpoint, this endpoint, this endpoint. Type C on the keyboard to close the keyboard. Hold down the shift key and your middle mouse button to edit. Press enter to repeat the 3D polyline command. Snap from this endpoint, this endpoint, this endpoint. Type C on the keyboard to close the figure. Go to the home tab, layer panel, click this down arrow and select the R8 layer. Now select this polyline, this 3D polyline. Go to the 3D tools tab, surface panel and select the plan command. Select this 3D polyline and select the plan command. Now select this surface, right click, select similar, right click, isolate, hide object. Use a crossing window selection to select all of these lines and hit delete on your keyboard. Right click, isolate, end object isolation to see the results. Now go to the home tab, click the down arrow and for the R6 layer, click into the drawing area. Now go to the home tab, layer panel and click the isolate command. Select this surface, this surface, this surface, press enter. AutoCAD isolates these layers. Type DI on your keyboard, press enter. As specified, first point point. Use the midpoint object snap and snap to the midpoint of this surface. Move the mouse cursor and snap to the midpoint of this surface. We need to reconstruct this roof again, the R7 roof. To do that, select this surface, right click and select similar, select this slab and this wall, right click, isolate, isolate object. Let's try and move this surface and see if we can solve this problem. Go to the home tab, draw panel and select the line command. As specified, first point point, click on this vertex, move the mouse cursor into this direction and click. Press escape to get out of command. Select this line, click the down arrow and move this object into the cabbage layer. Press escape to deselect the line. Or go to the home tab, draw panel and select the polygon command. At the enter number of side, type 8 on your keyboard, press enter. At the specified center point of polygon or edge point, type E on your keyboard and press enter. At the specified first endpoint of edge, click at the endpoint of this vertex, move the mouse cursor and click at the edge endpoint of this vertex. Go to the quick access toolbar and select the match property. As the select source object point, select this line. As the select destination object point, select this line. Press escape to get out of the command. Now go to the home tab, modify panel and select the offset command. As specified offset distance point, type 150 mm, press enter. Select this line and offset it inside. Press escape. Now select this surface, this surface, this surface, this surface, this surface. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the move command. At specifying this point point, use the midpoint object snap and snap to the midpoint of this line. Turn on the perpendicular object snap is not on and snap to this line. Select this roof and this surface, right click, select similar, hit delete on your keyboard to recreate this roof. Select this line and hit delete on your keyboard. Select this polygon right click, isolate object. Now go to the annotate tab, center panel, and select the center line command. Select this edge and this edge. Type DI on your keyboard, press enter, and specify first point point. Use the midpoint object snap and snap to the midpoint of this line. Move the mouse cursor, snap. Press F2 key. Highlight this figure and hold down the control key and type C on your keyboard to copy this figure. Click to the drawing area to close the text window. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the line command. And specify first point point. Use the midpoint object snap and snap to the midpoint of this line. Right click and select the quick call option, backspace. Hold down the control key and type V on your keyboard to paste this figure. Now multiply this figure by 0.75. Click the equals to, click apply. Move the mouse cursor into the Z axis and press enter. Press enter to end the command. Go to the quick access toolbar and select the match property. At the select source object prompt, select this polygon. At the select destination object prompt, select this object. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the make current button. Select this object and make it the current, make its layer the current layer. Go to the home tab, drop panel, click the down arrow and select the three polygon command. And specify first point point. Click at the end point of this line. Go to the status bar and turn off the auto mode. Click at the end point of this line. Type C on your keyboard and close the figure. Press enter to repeat the command. Start at the end point of this line. Type C on your keyboard and press enter to close the figure. Press enter to repeat the command. Start the polygon line this point and snap into this endpoint. Type C on your keyboard to close the figure. Go to the home tab, draw panel, and select the line command. And specify first point point. Click at the midpoint of this edge. Move the mouse cursor and snap to the endpoint of this vertical line. Move the mouse cursor and snap to the perpendicular to the opposite edge. Press enter to get out of the command. Select this line and this line. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the move command. And specifying base point point. Use the endpoint object snap and snap from this base point. Move the mouse cursor and snap to this base point. Go to the home tab, layer panel, click the down arrow and make the R7 layer the current layer. Now select this 3D polyline. Go to the 3D tools tab, surface panel, and select the plan command. AutoCAD convert this object into surface. Select this line. Go to the home tab, modeling panel, and select the extrude command. At the specific height of extrusion point, move the mouse cursor into this direction and type 6000 millimeter. Press enter. Select this surface, right click, select similar, right click, isolate, hide object. Use a window selection to select this line and hit delete on your keyboard. Right click, isolate, end object isolation. Now select this surface, right click, isolate object. Go to the home tab and make the cabbage layer the current layer. Zoom in into this area. Go to the home tab, drop panel, and select the line command. And specify first object prompt. Click at the endpoint of this line. Turn on off the auto mode if it's on, and use a perpendicular object now to snap to the perpendicular edge of this surface. Press enter to end the command. Press enter to start the line command. Repeat the same process on the opposite side. Press escape. Now select this line. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the move command. And specifying base point point, use this endpoint as a base point. Move the line into this endpoint. Now go to the home tab, layer panel, and select the make current button. Click this surface. Select this two line you just created. Go to the 3D tools tab, modeling panel, and select the extrude command. And specify extrusion endpoint. Snap into this endpoint. Now go to the visual style control. Click and select 2D wireframe. Select this surface. Click delete. select this surface, hit delete. Change the visual style back to realistic. Right click into the drawing area, isolate, and object isolation. Now we need to merge this surface into this surface. First, before we do, go to the 3D tool tab, surface panel, and select the chain command. Select this surface, this surface, this surface, press enter. Select this surface, this surface, this surface, press enter. Chain off this surface and this surface, press escape. Now select this surface and this surface, right click, isolate object. Go to the home tab, layer panel, and click the down arrow. Select the cabbage layer. Go to the home tab, drop panel, select the line command. Start a line from this endpoint and snap it to this endpoint. Press enter. Press enter to degrade the line command. At the specified first point, click on this point. Turn on the auto mode, move the mouse cursor into this direction and snap. Press enter to end the command. Go to the home tab, draw panel, click the down arrow and select the 3D polyline command. At specify first point, snap at this end point, snap at this intersection, this point, this point, this point, type C on your keyboard to close the figure. Select this surface and hit delete. Select this surface and hit delete. Now select this line and hit delete on your keyboard. Select this 3D polyline, go to the 3D tool tab, surface panel and click the plan. AutoCAD convert this surface into, convert the 3D polyline into surface. Use a window selection to select the surface, load the surface and the 3D polyline. Hold down the shift key and click on the surface. Hit delete on your keyboard. Right click into the drawing area, isolate, end object isolation. Now select this surface, this surface, and this surface. Right click, isolate object. Go to the 3D tools tab, surface panel, and click the trim command. Use a closing window to select all of the surface. Press enter. Use a closing window. Press enter again. Trim off this area, and trim off the internal part of this surface. Press escape to get out of the command. Right click, isolate, end object isolation. Now select this surface, this surface, this surface, and this surface. Right click, isolate object. Go to the 3D tool tab, surface panel, click down and select the trim command. Use a cursor window selection and select, press enter. Repeat the same process and press enter. Now trim off this surface. Hold down the shift key and your middle mouse button to edit. Trim off this portion. Press escape to get out of the command. Right click, isolate, end object isolation. Now we need to trim off this line and this surface. To do that, select this surface and this surface. Right click, isolate object. Go to the 3D tool tab, surface panel, click the down and select the trim command. Select this two surface, press enter. Select this two surface again, press enter. Now trim off this surface and this surface. Press escape, right click, isolate, end object isolation. Now select this surface, right click, select similar, right click, isolate object. Select this surface and hit delete on your keyboard. Right click, isolate, end object isolation. Go to the home tab, layer panel, and click the unisolate command, and click the third layer button to bring all of your roof. Alright, we're going to stop this video. In the next tutorial, we'll continue to construct our roof. If you find this tutorial useful, please click the like button and share it to your friends. If you have any question or you want a specific tutorial, please leave a comment below. If you want to continue this tutorial or any other tutorial on my channel, please subscribe. Thanks very much for watching. I hope to see you in the next class. Goodbye.